Good morning, bitch, and welcome to the morning tea with Lonnie Bee. See, that's what I'm saying. See, as you can see, it's just me and one asshole here, okay? It's just me and one asshole here today on the morning tea with Lonnie Bee. Let me tell y'all something, okay? Now, can I keep it real with my good girlfriends? First, let me let everybody know right now, I'm here with the ridiculous Ron.
What up,
okay? Come on. Ridiculous Ron, okay? Now, I want to get into something real quick, okay? Now, I know everybody out there in YouTube land, everybody out there in Zamunda, they love this show. They like the morning tea with Lonnie Bee. But what I want you guys to know, there's a lot of bullshit with this show. Okay? I want you to know that. You know I'm going to keep it real with my girlfriends, homeboys, and haters. Get comfortable. There's a lot of bullshit with this show. Okay? Now, I'm going to give you the breakdown of how this show works. Okay? First of all, when it comes to stories, everybody get an email, okay? So I know you're wondering in your head, well, damn, Lonnie, if everybody get their story before they come on the show, why when they get on the show, they be reading like Mike Tyson, okay? I guess I'm the only bitch to take it serious, okay? So then, after everybody get their email of what's supposed to go on to the show, everybody have to be at the show an hour early, okay? One bitch didn't show up yet! One bitch didn't show up yet, okay? But I'm sitting in here before everybody by myself, okay? And then one motherfucker come in here strolling 15 minutes before we go on live, all right? So I'm sitting in here by myself, okay? I guess I'm the only one that follow protocol. So do you care to share?
Well, I'm a firm believer of if you're going to tell a story, tell the whole story.
I'm telling the whole story.
Oh, no, you're not.
Okay, go ahead. Give on.
This last,
when I left
the
out.
Last couple of weeks, yes, you have been here before me.
Right.
But before that, no one gets here before me.
Okay.
Thank you.
And that's, okay, like you said, if you're going to tell the story, tell the whole story. You said, if I'm going to tell the story, tell the whole story, right?
Yes.
Okay. So you said nobody was getting here before you?
No, sir.
Was that the time one of the co-hosts didn't have a car and I was leaving from this side of town to go all the way on the other side of the town?
Yeah, that was.
Okay, so tell the whole story.
I mean, but we ain't putting all the details in there. I just was stating.
Oh, no, we're going to put all the details in there.
I was just stating that.
Because everybody say, oh, where's this person? Oh, where's this person? Bitch, you have no idea. Bitch, you have no idea. Bitch, you have no idea. You talk about where's this person? Where's this person? I'm gonna tell you what type of person I am. I'm the bitch that's not gonna stress herself out. No, I'm the one. Now, Ron, would you care to keep keep on telling? Go ahead.
I mean, that's pretty much it.
Okay, I'm finished. Everybody get their emails before.
Yeah, everybody get their emails before.
So explain, why do people come in here reading like Mayweather?
They probably can't read.
No, it's not that they can't read. All you do is gotta skim over the shit and put it into your own word, your own perspective.
Some people really don't feel.
You're right. One of the people. Fuck.
I know who you was aiming at.
So I'm trying to figure out.
I don't know, man.
Okay, so let's go to the next one since you can't answer that one. We're supposed to get here an hour before the show.
Yes.
Why isn't that happening when you coming from across the motherfucking street?
You got to talk to my orthopedic about that one.
Oh, come on, Ron.
Help
me out.
The last couple of weeks have been tough, but I have been here before our scheduled time.
Okay.
But on the average of 95%, at a time, ain't nobody gonna be here before me. I'm just professional.
I'm like always that. Here, Ron.
I'm professional. Like
I'm
that.
Always here.
Not before me.
Okay, let's get into it. You want to know more shit about the show? Let me give you more shit about the show. Okay? He's talking about here getting here on time. Let me tell you what I have to do, good girlfriends. Now, this is not about I. This is basically what it's doing is just making sure that we all are doing our duties, but do them in the form of a team so we can make this work.
I agree.
So, but when people start slacking of doing their duties, that's when Beyonce go the fuck solo. That's what happens. Okay? Because the hungry bitch don't want to be held back.
Oh, no.
Because a group of lazy motherfuckers.
You're right.
Okay? Okay, so let's keep going. So, let me tell you my duties of this show. Okay? You see the nice books we have? Ta-da. Bitch, now I'm Vanna White. You see the nice books? Now, you see all the stories and stuff in the book? Oh, here we go. Come on then. We're talking about duties of the show. We talking about duty. He just arrived. It's 11:09. He just arrived.
I'm so sorry. Okay.
You see the nice books, okay? Then inside the books is stories, okay? Stories, okay? You see the nice boxes and all of the questions and stuff in here? Inside is nice questions in every box, okay? All of that. Now, the next question is, Lonnie, who puts all of that together? That's the next question. Who puts all that together? Ron, would you like to answer?
Me.
I'm under a lot of stress. I'm dealing with two gay dudes on this fucking set.
Excuse me.
I'm fucking going through it, man. Excuse me for not being perfect.
Who got to go to your edge? You go ahead, motherfucker.
I'm sorry. I'm going through a lot of stress right now.
Okay. So, Ron, no. Who puts all that together?
You do.
Okay.
But I did say you should put more onus on us and allow us to put more pressure on ourselves to come up with certain
things. Okay, good.
Get out of there on that.
And I'm glad you said that. You did say that.
Okay.
But how can I put more responsibilities on you when you across the street and can't get here on time?
No.
So how can I rely on you when you can't do something simple?
You're trying to fucking sabotage.
I'm not sabotaging. We just keeping it real.
I'm always on time.
How can I rely on you when you can't be on time?
The show starts at 11.
The show starts at 11.
Today I'm saying 10:35.
But what's the call time? That's not the call time.
10:15.
You have to be here.
As of 2 weeks ago.
I'm sitting here by myself, bitch, talking to Darnell.
Oh, Darnell can answer this. Yes. Let Darnell intervene on this. I be here 10:15 and y'all be late as shit.
That's because that's what before Simi had the car and I had to come from this side and go over there.
That was 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm.
Okay?
That was 2 weeks ago.
So don't do that, Ron. That was 2 weeks ago, sweet lips. I'm living in my truth.
That was 2 weeks ago, sweet lips.
Okay?
2 weeks ago, Tuck.
No, let me tell you something, you bald head piece of fat back. Let me tell you something right now. Okay? If we're going to tell the truth, we're going to tell the whole truth.
And nothing but the truth.
This is a team effort.
You're right.
This is a team effort. Okay? People wonder why groups and stuff that don't work, because it's always people that start slacking.
True.
So is it fair for the people that's hungry? The person that's hungry should deal with that. Is that fair?
Maybe we should ask Sammy.
First of all, let me tell you something right the fuck now. One thing about me, you can say, yeah, I was late. I've been late a couple of times.
We are gonna
one thing
that.
About me, I'm a team player. That's number one.
Okay.
Because in the beginning, I was giving didn't mother fucking washing out mugs. You already wasn't doing
tell fuck, your duties. What, tell your duties.
Doing mug duties or none of that shit. I was setting up
there
these posts that
again.
You say.
There you go, lying again. Y'all ain't coming.
In the
ahead.
Beginning? Y'all in the beginning coming. Wrong.
That's because you was playing housewife to the show.
Man. Right up on the show.
So, nah, but
second of all, I play my position. Third of all, I slay when I tell my story.
I think everybody do, but I feel what Lonnie's saying.
Well, whatever.
I feel what he's saying, though.
Well, first of all, we had a meeting not too long ago, right? That said that we was going to find our own stories and stuff like that, right?
I agree. Yes, we did.
Yeah,
but we can't find our own stories if we can't do the little things that we're supposed to do, like arrive on time at the call.
I'm sorry. Like arrive on time on the call time.
We got to first accomplish the little things before you get promoted to the next job.
French fries.
You see,
next
let me tell you something.
On the fries.
Let me tell you something. That's why I'm telling you now. That's why it's very important that when you do something, you got to do it by your motherfucking self. Because people do not take your shit serious. People don't
true.
Take your shit serious. He's not taking the shit. He's talking about french fries and shit.
You say
I'm on the ball egg. I'm on the ball motherfucking egg.
King size.
Yes. Your head.
You said promotion. I say we're going to get promoted to the fries.
No, you know what I'm saying? But it's the little things.
Nah,
so can't. I'm just here to let everybody know, okay? One day, you might turn on the morning tea with Lonnie B. And somebody might be replaced. Latavia might be gone, and there may be a Michelle. One of the Temptations might be gone, okay?
Ooh.
Bobby might be gone, and there may be Johnny. But you gotta understand that and why. I gotta keep it real. The show must go on. Okay? The show must go on.
Yeah, I knew it was real when Lil Mo got fired.
Yeah, Lil Mo got fired. You're not exempt. Fuck.
And she was rubbing people probably the wrong way before they said, yes, this is it.
So I just had to let my good girlfriends and homeboys know what's going on behind the scenes here at the morning tea with Lonnie Bee. You know what I'm saying? We ain't gonna do no mystery shit. We gonna let you know what's going on. The bitch don't work here no more. Simple as that. Okay? For real, simple as that. I don't give a damn.
I don't give a goddamn.
I don't give a damn who you like. No disrespect to you, good girlfriends and homeboys or haters. But we can't be holding down for the person that you like. Fuck. The show must go on. Okay, good morning. Now it's time for the morning tea with Lonnie Bee.
Pink slips are on the table.
Yes,
bitch.
The pink slips are on the table. Yes. Okay, and the pen is ready to start. Yes, okay. Shit, you know what I'm saying? It's a lot going on, Ron. You feel me?
I feel you.
I'm prepared for this show. Then I got to get ready to go on a tour. You know what I'm saying, Ron?
I know you're excited about that.
I'm very excited.
We're going to have a good time.
We're going to have a good time. And I'm excited as shit, but this is draining as fuck.
I hope you
no, don't
flight.
Do that.
Sitting here, waiting on you, and Ron still ain't do what he was supposed to do. Let me tell you why. For those of you that keep asking for D, there's a story with that shit. So if you want to know, shit, I'll give you every motherfucking thing. Because that's just the type of person I am. We don't have to hold nothing back. We all family here in Zamunda, okay? He goes outside and shit when he ain't supposed to. So when you go outside when you ain't supposed to, you know what I'm saying? The law be on you like shit. Yeah. And they tell you, okay, now you can't go no motherfucking where. Yeah. So now we got to get letters, petitions and stuff to prove to his probational officer that this is where D is going to be. Even though this motherfucking show is all on the web with D, they don't give a fuck. No, they just want him to sit there. Okay, you know how the law acts. You know what I'm saying? They petty. But to avoid all of that, if you don't do the crime, you don't have to worry about nobody watching your time on where the fuck you are.
That's true.
Okay? That's so true. Any more motherfucking questions?
No.
Okay.
Let's keep it moving.
Good morning. I ain't going to let a bitch upset me because I ain't going to be that way. But I'm going to tell the bitch the truth because I'm living in my truth. Good morning. Yes.
Well, that was interesting.
Ron, you went to New York. Tell us why.
Oh, man. I went to see my girl. A lot of people might not know, but I got the biggest crush on Elvana. And I went up there to see her in a concert at the BB King. Man, she put on a great show. A great show. Her vocals were good on point. Her performance was good. Her band was on point. She had Algebra. I don't know if y'all familiar with her, but she opened up for her. And this other guy, I can't remember his name, man. I feel bad because I really enjoyed him. I'm going to find out who he is. He put on a great show, too. He opened up for, but yeah, man, I got a big crush on Yvonne.
Right. Did you enjoy yourself? Did you get to meet her?
Nah, I ain't do all of that. Like, I could have, like.
What was the performance at?
The BB King.
Is that a nice place?
Oh, where?
Yeah, it's real cool. Mm-hmm.
Did she enjoy herself?
Who, Yvonne?
You, I thought you took a lady friend.
Yeah, I did take a lady friend.
Okay,
yeah,
he left her out. He left that bitch out.
Yes, he forgot about her out there. Yes.
Who was the lady you took with you?
Stop being nosy.
See, I didn't even ask you.
Yeah,
she
did. She did have a nice time, yeah.
Oh, she had a nice time? Yeah, what did y'all do afterwards?
Huh?
What did y'all do afterwards?
Got something to eat, I believe.
Well,
some joint called Joint's. Food was nasty as shit, man.
Oh really, Ron? You normally know all the good spots.
Well, in that part of town, I didn't. We stayed in Manhattan.
So you don't know all the good spots.
So after that y'all ate that nasty food, did you get some good dessert? Yeah. You got some good dessert. So that was your Valentine's Day.
Yeah, that was my Valentine's Day. Then we chilled up there. We left last night. But, New York's starting to grow on me. That was my second time up there. It's starting to grow on me.
Really?
I never really.
I love New York. Yeah. I love New York. My good girlfriends are there.
Yeah.
Me neither.
Yes. Oh, okay. Well, that's good. So what did you do last night? Let's keep it sweet because he always got a book. What did you do last night that got you coming in here late?
Don't be mad.
Well, who did you do? Give it to us.
I didn't do anyone yet, okay? I haven't had any since fucking 2017 came in, okay?
What time did you go to bed? Because you got your sleep goggles on.
Well, actually, I was driving, so, you know, I was late, so I just noticed. I was like, I stay still on, but I can sleep for more, yes. Because, you know, I had my morning jag. But I just been getting a lot of sleep. I'm working on four shows, and I'm just now realizing it. Two plays, a fashion show, and a tour.
Yes.
Yeah.
Two plays, a fashion show, City of Peace, and the kids' fashion show at Payne.
And the City of Peace, the two plays, the City of Peace, the core cast, and alumni. They doing alumni.
So don't tell me you was hanging out last night and you got all this stuff ahead of you.
Well, not quite.
Okay, what was you doing last night? Come on, Sammy.
I slept.
No, you didn't. You was slept. Was you sleep standing up?
Yes.
Fuck like a bat. You was outside.
And twerking, too.
See, you was outside.
Listen.
What time did you go to bed last night?
3.
Damn.
See what I'm saying? See what I'm saying?
But you know I go out on Wednesdays.
What y'all doing? Y'all was hanging out?
You know I go to the pool on Wednesdays.
Okay, well, let me tell you something about the pool hall. Okay, let me tell you something about the pool hall. The pool hall is a place that's already established.
Mm-hmm.
We are working on getting semi-established.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to get your, you are working, but you need to get your rest in order to prepare for your build-up.
I just said, because I really...
Rest is important, Sammy.
But listen,
I have... You're going to start looking like Eartha Kitt.
No, I won't. Because listen, I really have been going... I haven't been hanging out. Vamp and Vicky has been in. The last time I really went out... with Saturday and then Baltimore when we went out, but I've been going to sleep late, but I just said, fuck it, I wanted to go out last night, so I went the fuck out.
But I'm going to tell you something what I learned while doing all that I'm doing. Going out is always going to be there.
Mm-hmm.
You only get one shot to go after your dream.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. You're right.
So get your rest.
You're right.
All right. Mm-hmm. I love y'all. I got to look out for my friends. I got to look out for my friends, okay?
That's right.
Yes. All right. So here we go. Let's get into the tea. Mm-hmm. All right.
He told you.
Let's get into the tea.
Listen, I can receive it wrong. That's why.
See, you want to let him get you going. That's what that's his job. He likes to get people going.
Yeah.
But he won't tell us what he did with that woman. Somebody's daughter.
See, I'm living in my truth.
Yeah, somebody's daughter. Okay? You can't even say her name.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to get sued.
Yeah.
Allegedly.
Okay, well, since we're talking about Valentine's Day, what everybody did, I got some tea what happened on Valentine's Day. A 92-year-old man fatally shot his wife on Valentine's Day.
Jeez. What?
He was 92 years old.
These old people are going off.
And guess how old was his wife?
Young.
72.
Oh, shit. Oh, okay.
That's the fuck, what you mean? Oh, okay, that's the fucked up way to go out.
I mean, it is. I thought she was about to say 37.
That's what I thought he was about to say.
No, she was 72. Okay? A 92-year-old man shot and killed his 72-year-old wife after getting to an argument on Valentine's Day. Yes! I don't know what the fuck they could have been arguing about. Okay? Her biting into a chocolate with her dentures. I don't know what the fuck, but it's not worth getting killed over.
Nah.
It's not worth getting killed
it's
over.
Not.
Okay? Police said it was a domestic dispute between the Murray couple. Okay, and it turned deadly on Tuesday night around 8 p.m. All right, and this happened in South L.A.
Shit.
This is crazy. This is crazy. Yes, they say after the argument, the man got a shotgun and then shot his wife, police say. The woman died at the scene, and the man has been taken into custody. Okay, and this investigation is ongoing.
Dang.
This is crazy.
I really want to know why he shot her, though. I can't.
An argument, but it can't be that serious. Bitch, leave.
It can't be.
I don't mean to laugh.
Divorce. You know, like, what the fuck?
Yeah, that's sad.
So y'all know Carlos Santana.
Yeah, famous guitar.
Yeah, he had a lot to say about Adele and Beyonce.
Ooh, what'd he say?
Yes. So Carlos Santana has offered up his 2 cents regarding why Adele beat Beyonce for Album of the Year.
Mm.
Okay, now, have you heard both albums? Adele and Beyonce's?
I haven't heard Adele new.
Well, I got both of the albums, okay? And they're different music, okay? Right. Adele's I can be settled to, you know what I'm saying? I can just ease my mind, think of my thoughts, you know what I'm saying? Reflect over my life. Beyonce, I'm ready to look for my dude and fuck him up. You know, those are two different albums, okay? But anyway, this is what Carlos had to say. He says, I think Adele won because she actually can sing.
Wow.
And Beyonce can't.
Wow.
Ooh.
That's what he said.
Ooh, ooh.
He said Adele sings. Beyonce don't really sing. That's what he said.
Now, I respect Carlos Santana. But
I respect him too.
That's a
but come on
comment.
Now, Beyonce can't sing.
And the award isn't about who could sing better. What was the award? The best album, right?
Well, the Grammys to me is about popularity.
I mean, I agree, but...
Because Adele album sold more than Beyonce.
It's about popularity.
But was it really better than Lemonade? Exactly. That's
that,
the question.
And who was that panel that's making all the motherfucking decisions?
The Grammys have always been about popularity
I
to
agree.
Me.
I agree.
Whoever them certain people are that's making the decision.
Yeah, and they base it off of popularity.
Right.
Yeah, they're what they sold the most.
But just because you sing better than a person don't mean they're the more deserving of the award. I mean, I disagree with that. And I think Beyonce can sing.
Beyonce really can sing. She we can can't sing. Take that away from now. Her. Regardless of how many people don't like her, you can't take away from the girl. The girl can sing.
So, and okay? She can perform. She's a fucking machine. Okay?
And that's what I was going to say.
Cause go off.
Yeah, because okay. What if he would have said, well, would somebody say, well, Beyonce can perform way better than Adele?
Listen to what he actually said. Carlos said, with all due respect, I respect the sister Beyonce. Beyonce is very beautiful to look at and ooh, more likely a model kind of music.
Wow.
Basically, what he's saying is that she get by the way that she look and the leotard she put on and the fan that blows her hair.
He must have wanted to work with her and she gave no. Because he's making absolutely
so
no
sense. So that's what she said.
I agree. I ain't making no
he
sense.
Said,
he
said, making no sense. Then he goes to say, Adele can sing. She doesn't bring all those dancers and those props and all of those visual effects. She stand there in the ball gowns and she sings.
Yeah. Okay. But at the same time.
This is where it stops.
Hold up, Carlos.
Hold the fuck
Carlos,
up.
Carlos going off like a lady.
Yeah, that's a con. Better one.
Carlos going off like a lady. Okay, so go ahead. Say what you're about to say, Sammy.
I'm going to say this. Now, it's certain levels of artists. Now, if you care for the artist that stands there and sings mm-hmm. and belts out her vocals in a cute little gown and a good light, then
like a Whitney
mm-hmm.
or Mariah
mm-hmm. then that's your preference and that's okay, right? Mm-hmm. But if you wanted the children then want a girl that can sing a little bit and swirl and perform for
yeah.
you, then that's what you don't bash and don't compare the two,
right?
They're two
I
different
think
types.
They're two different types totally of artists. Two different types.
Totally different.
Yeah, so that's what he said. So then you know the Beehive, bitch. They don't play. They stink.
The
Beehive don't play. They come.
They put those stinkers out.
They bring those stinkers out and they go for your fucking neck, bitch.
And your eyes.
Yes, bitch. And they dare you to go to the doctor. Bitch, for real. They go for you.
So no, then you go to the doctor.
Yes, bitch. The Beehive had shit to say. So after they attacked Carlos, he came back on Facebook and made another statement. He said, I would like to clarify my comment.
I bet.
Yes. He said that was reported when I was doing an interview for some upcoming shows in Australia and New England. He said, my intent was to congratulate Adele on her amazing night at the Grammys. My comment about Beyonce was taken out of context. He said, I have the utmost respect for her as an artist and as a person, and she deserved all that she gets coming her way. And I wish Beyonce and her family all the best.
Can I ask y'all a question?
I hear the violin.
What he said when he said it.
Do y'all think that's fucked up though, that a man can't have an opinion? Like them Beehive women are fucking nuts. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people
you know
backtrack.
What? You can have an opinion, but be very careful.
But you think that like
you can have an opinion, but be very
because a lot of people backtrack.
Be very careful
of what you say.
What the fuck,
but go ahead, what you say? A lot of people do backtrack after the Beehive come.
Like, and that's power, man. Mm-hmm. Like, I've seen a lot of people say with how they really feel about Beyonce, and I think you have that right, man. By the time them people get off their ass, man, a lot of people going back on what they say.
It's like a big ass swarm coming at you with a whole bunch of millions of bees.
Uh-huh.
Change what you said. Change it.
But I disagree to what he said because of the simple fact that she really can sing.
I disagree.
She really can sing. She really could sing.
That was coming from a better place.
Mm-hmm. He was upset, you know?
Mm-hmm. And then the Beehive gave him a fucking attitude.
Oh, the Beehive came, bitch, like honey was on his skin. They stung the shit out of him.
Attitude adjustment.
Yes! Okay, well, since we're talking about the Beehive and Beyonce, let's talk about Solange. Solange tweets and deletes her Grammy shade after her sister Beyonce album of the year. So she had something to say and she deleted. This is my thing about tweeting and deleting and going back on your word. If you're not going to stand beside it, don't say it.
Yeah, just shut the fuck up.
If you don't believe in it, don't write it. Right. That's how I feel. You know what I'm saying? That's just how I feel. But anyway, I love Solange. That's my good girlfriend. Solange defend her sister Beyonce after the Grammy Award, Album of the Year, Record of the Year, and all a well song of the year to Adele. Then she delete her words. First, Solange tweeted a link that Frank Ocean wrote on his Tumblr. The post that accuses the Grammy as cultural bias. Okay, we talked about that on the show before. When Taylor Smith beat Kendrick Lamar at Album of the Year in 2014. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. So, then Solange offers some words of advice to her followers on Monday afternoon. She says, create your own committees. She says, build your own institutions. And she tweeted, give your friends awards and award yourself and be the gold you want to be. She says, Solange followed up with a Grammy not so fun fact about the lack of Blacks Album of the Year winners. She said, there have only been 2 Black winners in the last 20 years of Album of the Year. And there have been over 200 Black artists who have performed. Then she deleted the tweets.
I didn't know that shit. I didn't know it either.
Yeah, because I think I'm not that interested in the Grammys.
I agree. And they're not either. But this is my thing.
Can I say this? And then I'm going to let y'all talk before I forget it, because it's at the top of my head. This is my thing when it comes to Grammys, BET, and, you know, American Music Awards, Oscars, or any of those things. I really don't give a fuck about those trophies that's going to sit in the attic, collect dust, and break. The biggest reward is the reflection of the people. Of how you affect the people. That's the biggest award. How you're changing lives. That's the biggest award. Why we get so uptight over people judging us about our own personally craft that we created for us?
Well said.
You can't award my talent because you wouldn't understand my talent because I created my talent.
Right.
Right.
So how can you reward something that you don't know nothing about?
I agree.
Or where it's coming from?
Well, your talent is God-given.
Yeah, my talent is God-given. Right. And the award that I get is continue being blessed by him because I'm pleasing and touching people. So those awards mean shit.
I agree.
I don't mean to come off as Louis Farrakhan, the gay one, but I'm just, you know, expressing my opinion. What do y'all think?
I think you are.
I think they're not meant to... say, okay, this is Lonnie B or this is whoever won the award. It's just a object of gratitude to show your hard work and all of that. I don't think it should define who you are.
Right.
But I don't understand how all of those celebrities with all this money they have, the Blacks I'm talking about, they really care about what them people think. Because they keep continuously going to support the program. When they get invited. It's an invite.
Right.
You don't have to come. Y'all put together what you feel how your people should be celebrated and honored.
Right.
It might not be a trophy. It might be something else. But y'all have that ability and the power to do that, to have your own Grammys and name it whatever you want. Like something separate from the BETs, which is kind of hood and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
But have your own classy award show with red carpet and everybody wear the tuxes and flash shit or whatever. Do it. Like stop caring about what these people think about you.
Right.
And do your own thing.
That's very true. And you know what else? I'm not too much of a fan of award shows because I'm over the era of competing with other people. Right. Like, I'm over that. You know what I'm saying? Okay. In this day and time, I'm not even with that. But I do actually appreciate those honor shows.
Right.
Those shows that honor people. Like, I really like those shows.
Okay.
For honoring people of their legacy and what they have done and how they changed lives and did stuff for the communities and stuff like that. I like those shows.
Kind
of sort of like Steve Harvey Hoodie Awards or the Neighborhood Awards.
Yeah,
he changed that. But that's a great award show.
Right.
You know? I just think people put too much energy.
But you know what?
I think that's great.
When we got older, the award shows seemed a little bit duller and a little bit colder. But when we were younger, award shows used to give a little honor in it too, all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? More, you know what I mean?
Right.
I love award shows. Like I don't know why I still haven't figured it out.
Yeah, that hoodie award show is great.
The hoodie, oh my God. I was blessed enough to go 1 year and it was. Awesome.
Okay, so let's move on to some more tea. Good girlfriends, homeboys, haters, and tea party. Yes. So Drake repeatedly offered to talk a suicide man down for jumping off of the bridge in England.
What?
Yeah.
That's what's up.
Drake, reportedly offered to talk a suicide man down from jumping off of a bridge while he was in England.
Yes.
So he's driving. He's driving on his tour bus, and his tour bus is stuck in traffic, and he can't figure out why the fuck his tour bus not moving. Okay, mind you, this is the reason why he wasn't at the award show neither, because he was touring over in England. Okay, he wasn't at the Grammys. So he's trying to figure out why is his tour bus not moving. Come to figure out, they stop in traffic because it's a man that's on the other side of the road about to jump off the bridge. So one of Drake's security people got off the bus and asked the police officer, hey, Drake want to talk to the man. Is it possible that Drake can talk to the man? So Drake went over there, talked to the man, and talked the man out of jumping off of the bridge.
Oh.
I don't know if he talked or sing the tune, but the man didn't jump. Good job for you, Drake.
Yes, that was man. So beautiful.
Now, what you got to say about that, Ron?
I don't believe that shit, man.
You don't believe that?
These fucking PR
Look it up.
People, man. These PR people are something, man. They good.
Look it up.
That sound like what kind of like...
So you think this story is fabricated?
I think it's very fabricated, but I would hope it's true. If he did do something like that, man, kudos to that man. But they try to make Drake some type of superhero, man. Like, he can't do no wrong.
And it's you're just, mad.
It's possible. Mad. No, you're jealous.
I like Drake. I like his music.
You sure you like him?
I like Drake.
Look at the camera and tell the people you're not jealous.
No, I'm not.
Now, look at the YouTube camera and tell the people you're not jealous. You're jealous.
No, man.
You wanted to save that man. Just because you're a fire man, you're mad because a rapper saved him and not the firefighter.
It's just that it sounds like Muhammad Ali's story. And they just, like, they just trying to make this man bigger than life, man.
Right.
But I mean,
and you're in this rubbing you the wrong way.
Nah. If he really did do it, though, it just sounded like bullshit.
Well, who are you to say? Okay.
Right. Okay. Come on, Ron.
Like bullshit.
So, okay. Do y'all remember the Prison Bay? Jeremy Meeks?
The little model dude?
Yeah,
the
one that got famous and shit off of his mugshot.
Right.
Well, he broke out his runway debut at New York's Fashion Week this week.
Ooh.
And he shed it down.
Damn, for
real. Yeah.
This is the land of the free. Anything can happen in America. There's no excuse why motherfuckers are sitting at home being bums.
Yeah.
There's no excuse. This man got a career off of a mugshot. We got to get creative.
I'm trying to tell you.
I was happy. But he didn't
have no excuse.
He didn't get creative about it. That's just something that just happened.
It did just happen, but he took advantage of it and ran with it. Yeah. He could have just settled for Instagram fame.
Yeah.
But he ran with that. He got him a motherfucking PR person. He got an agent, and they started booking him shows.
That is true, but it was people that was actually seeking him, too. He became like the Holy Grail, honey.
Right, and he took it and ran with it.
I mean...
See, some people just can settle just for attention. He made that shit out of a career.
Yeah.
That's big!
Why do you want him?
And
he might go down as
one of them big time model dudes too. Cause I heard about he made a lot of noise up there joint.
Yeah, he made a lot of noise.
They was talking about him when I just was up there.
That was something that was in the path of his life.
Right. But he took advantage of his opportunity.
Sometimes we miss out
opportunities when it's right in front of us. Sometimes we do.
Yeah.
Sometimes we really do.
Sometimes you don't. And the only time them opportunities really don't come if you have negative thoughts and you block it.
That's not true.
That is true.
Sometimes opportunities smack you right in the face. And if you don't have the wits to notice it and take advantage of it and to go.
But who's to say that it can't happen again? So you say it can't happen again?
Fuck no.
See?
But
opportunity like he got. That shit don't come three times.
It's just like the Eminem song. That's one shot. True, but you got to lose yourself.
Sometimes.
Who done had two opportunities
again?
That you know?
I'm Philippe and I said who? I don't know, bitch. Google it.
So you making up shit.
I'm not making up shit.
Because this them type of opportunities
see,
don't
you're
come.
You're just jaded. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know what
sometimes,
that means, but...
look that up.
No, too. I'm not.
So anyway...
But I will tell
sometimes
you them type of opportunities
sometimes you're never on the wrong path.
You like
sometimes things happens, and even though you think that you off your path, God and the universe would put you back. Who to say that for him getting locked up or whatever he got locked
Hold
up
Hold on,
up,
what's the universe?
Where we live at.
I believe in God. That's
God
it.
And the universe.
I believe in God.
Okay. Because you're a nut.
No, you threw me off with the universe. Because you're a nut. Universe. I'm thinking of Spaceballs and Star Wars.
Well, I'm sorry that you feel that way.
Not Murray and Moses.
Uh-huh. I'm sorry that you feel that way.
Okay, but go ahead.
Okay. Sometimes things come back around.
Okay.
And I just asked. Since you're saying that, give me a scenario where that has come.
Scenario with... these nuts. How about that?
No, seriously, dude. Like, when that man, now I can see if you said he got locked up and his opportunity came, and if he didn't get locked up, that opportunity wouldn't have came. I can understand
so
that.
So it still came from somewhere. It was setting him up. It was the path.
You're
he
right.
Didn't know.
Before it to come twice?
You don't. Sometimes it does. The fuck? If you don't believe it, I don't give a fuck. But the truth is, it's the truth.
It ain't about me believing. I'm just asking
the name. But that thing, he didn't even know. Sometimes you don't even know what is in store for you. And this shit just happens. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you be going through a badass time and don't even know what the badass time is about. And to hindsight, when you be like, oh, if this ain't happened, that ain't happened, woo, wah, wah, I wouldn't have been here. Mm-hmm. Shit does happen.
That's true.
Now moving right the fuck along. Mm-hmm. Shit.
But I agree with you, Ron. I only think you get one opportunity, and that opportunity comes, you have to seize that moment. You know, because that's just like me. I had an opportunity to do things with, you know, in dance, and I never got those opportunities again. You know what I'm saying? But now that I'm doing this, I got this opportunity, and I took advantage of this opportunity.
Right.
But check- so I learned from missing that opportunity due to the fact that I didn't take that opportunity, and I knew it wasn't going to come again. The next opportunity that would come, I was going to jump on it.
Okay.
And I think that's what he did. He jumped on his
opportunity. So let me say this, then she want to say that. Let's use you as an example. Mm-hmm. You have always been funny from day one. Mm-hmm. You taught dance because that's something that you love. Mm-hmm. You went into music, did all that to all come back to what you originally do. Mm-hmm. That you at first was like, I don't think I can make a living or be funny and be this and be that. Mm-hmm. But exactly, that's what you're doing right now. Mm-hmm. But it went from one phase to the next phase, and it got you. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That dance opportunity wasn't meant for you.
Right. But what I'm saying was it was a dance opportunity was presented to me, and I didn't take that opportunity.
But it wasn't meant for you.
But if I would have took that opportunity, I probably would be in the field of dance.
But it wasn't meant for you.
Right. Things don't happen for, I mean, everything happened for a reason.
Exactly.
You're right. That's what I'm saying. But what I'm saying to you is that opportunity that was there for me never came again. That's what Ron is saying. But the opportunities, the same opportunity don't come around multiple times. That's what Ron's saying.
What I'm saying is the opportunity to become big and have a bigger platform, regardless of if it's through dance or if you would have made it rapping, mm-hmm. it still came back. Mm-hmm. This is what you're doing right now.
What, dancing?
No. Being funny, being yourself, like you don't.
But during that time, I wasn't. No, but what I'm saying to you is do what I, with that opportunity that came to me at first, was not the opportunity that I'm doing now.
But
it was two different leads. I was working with children and teaching children dance. Now I'm at a different lead in my life, doing a whole different agenda.
I understand that.
That's what
but
I'm saying.
But if you really took the opportunity and became larger than life, you still would have been known and been kind of famous or whatever like that. Mm-hmm. Either way, you still came out. Same platform. You're more numb. You got larger than life. It's just that she wasn't going to get larger than life. And that opportunity of being a dance teacher
He kind of different, though, because this guy was fucking in jail. He had
It was still something that his life path led him to, whatever it was.
You messing up what I'm saying.
I understand what you're saying. Y'all understand what I'm saying.
That motherfucker, if he didn't take advantage of that shit, he was going back to jail. Not to say he was or he wasn't, but the chances, the percentages of that man having a successful life, not taking advantage of that, is very slim to none.
I understand that, but some opportunities you get, you be dumb as shit not to take them because it's just that big.
Right.
But my point big is, when you think those opportunities that you missed in your life that you probably looked at as a mistake before a lot of stuff happened then, it's not a mistake. It's leading you to where you're supposed to be going. And that's what I'm saying. So in that case, it does come back around, just come in a different way.
I mean, what you're saying makes sense. I get it.
Okay, let's move on to the next story. Okay, so here is the story. Now, this story is about our homeboy Kanye West.
Kanye.
Now, apparently Kanye West is suffering from memory loss.
Shit, what that did to Kanye, man?
They said he is suffering from it. Now, I'm kind of fickle with this story because I'm trying to figure out, is it memory loss or he just regret the shit that he was saying?
It's a lot of regret today. What the fuck is regret Thursday?
Yeah, but I'm trying to figure that out, you know, because, you know, he just recently started back talking to Jay-Z and them.
Okay.
So I'm trying to figure out, he's like, oh man, I don't even remember what I said. You know? So they won't feel no type of way towards him.
Yeah.
So anyway, a long time friend of Kanye West, his name is Malik. He had updated some of the meter on the Grammys red carpet, and he said that Kanye is suffering from memory loss, okay? Since he was hospitalized in November. He said, but Kanye has been in the house sitting down with his kids. You know what I'm saying? And he's been talking to Kanye for 6 and 7 hours. And he's really, really trying to recover from his memory loss. And I don't know what to think about this story. But I just don't know what to think. Girlfriends, I don't know what to think.
See, with him, you never know, though. That's the whole thing. Because he possibly, with the type of shit going on in his life, he could possibly be going through some, like, some mental shit where he's forgetting shit, though.
Well, he's been diagnosed with a lot of shit.
Yeah, man. I think he's really going through a lot of shit, though. I really do.
I think that allegedly.
One of my good girlfriends, Felicia, said drug use.
No, I think when his ass went
on. Rhonda said regret saying and doing a lot of shit.
When they had his ass detained, claiming that he was having a mental breakdown, they was giving him some type of shock therapy, bitch. Making him start, nyah, nyah, nyah. You still want to speak out? Nyah, nyah, nyah.
Okay, nyah, give nyah, us nyah. Your tea, Ron. What you got for us today? Did you read it?
Yes, I did.
Okay, here we go. Fuck.
Burger King offers an adult meal complete with special adult toys for Valentine's Day. So Burger King wanted to make sure you can have it your way when it comes to both your burger and the bedroom this Valentine's Day. So Burger King basically gave you three options to pick with your adult meal. You have to pick the adult meal. So you got a Satan mask, a feather duster, and a scalp massager. Sorry, satin mask.
Okay.
I had a Tyson moment. Sorry.
So they giving out freaky shit in their adult meal.
And this was it wasn't.
You think you're getting a hot dog and you get a dildo?
You would have got the scalp massager.
Let me see. Feather dildo, yeah, the scalp.
I don't even know what the fuck that shit is. That's terrible.
This was in Israel. This wasn't even in the United States, so
I'm sure.
Yeah,
I'm sure this was out of the country.
Well, the satin mask is like that, you know, that shiny and got the little white lace around it.
Oh, okay.
Real, like, erotic.
Yeah.
On Madonna.
Yeah, I was about to say it's giving Madonna.
That's giving Dirty Maid.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
The scalp massager.
That would just be, that just sound nasty.
With your food, though.
Yeah, right? With your food.
Yeah.
Yes, you go pick up some french fries and lubrication. Oh, my God. That's just nasty. I wouldn't want that.
Yeah.
Oh my Ooh, God. And this shit.
I don't want a feather dust.
If this shit made the news, I wouldn't want feather dust on my burger. That's nasty.
Yeah, I don't want none of that type of shit with my food.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. So let me bring this story to y'all that I was having with one of my best friends, okay? Shout out to Quentin, okay? I don't know if I should have said that.
I love Quentin.
I don't know if I should have said that because he probably said, why you tell that story? Well, anyway.
You shouldn't
So
do that,
anyway,
Judy.
It's okay. It's okay. We've been friends for years. He know me. So anyway, so I was wondering about things like this. When it comes to like groups and people doing things together, like for those of you that don't know, Quentin does image consulting. So he works with different artists and he dress them. Like he go get their clothes and shit, whatever budget they get, he makes it work, okay? You give him $20, he's gonna come back with some nice pairs of socks, okay? So he just make it work, you know? So he was working with a group of people and apparently they split ways, you know? And some of them split ways because of different egos and some of them split ways because of how the audience could play them against each other. So I said, I want to have that conversation with the Tea Party. Because that happens.
A lot.
That happens. Viewers and people out here that watch us can play us against each other. Y'all like know that can, you... that happens. But the thing that I didn't understand was, how was your mind so weak to let outside people break up your inside house?
But see, that's the thing. Like, that's the actual thing that you actually need experiencing. Because you have,
right.
to have the tools,
right.
the tools and the mindset
right.
To deal with that.
Right.
Because it really, it's almost like a version of reverse psychology if you let it
right.
happen.
Right. So, Ron, what would you do? Just hypothetically speaking, not to say that this ever happened before. I don't know. Okay. But just what would you do if somebody was to come to you from a different network and say, Ridiculous Ron, I want to do a show with you, but I don't want you to bring them two faggots. No, come on. Let's have a conversation. But I don't want you to bring them two faggots because I feel like they tarnish your brand. Okay. You come off, you know what I'm saying, as a masculine man. You don't need them soft piece of tissues next to you.
Yeah, we'll get you some real wet.
And then we're going to give you $1 million. But first, you got to walk away and cancel your contract with those two faggots.
Okay.
What would you, honestly, let me tell you something. I don't want you to even answer if you're going to fucking lie.
I ain't going to fucking lie.
Okay. I think you're going
to
lie.
Okay, I don't want you to answer if you're going to lie. So go ahead. What would you do?
Lie.
Go ahead. I mean, first I'd be like, well, what I said, motherfucker? Get them the fuck away from me. What I said, motherfucker?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
I'm a dumb ass crush you was that. Fuck I said, motherfucker.
I am ready.
Oh, everybody calm down.
Oh, my God.
Shit.
So.
But I ain't gonna lie, on a serious note, though, I'm a man of principle. I would definitely get the deal structured where my crew coming with me. Mm-hmm. I'm a real loyal dude, man. And I mean, and for real, $1 million ain't shit for real, man. I really would bring my people with me, man.
Mm-hmm.
Like, cause I'd be working with a crew that I ain't enjoying. The fucking shit probably be boring or some shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm all about my team winning.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I will say this. You ain't gonna make no stupid decision. And I definitely, if I was to accept like some money from a different situation, I'm gonna still have my situation, but it's gonna be to make that money work for us at the same time type mm-hmm. of thing. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
It'll be like that.
Right. Okay. Now, Sammy, when it comes to you, like, how would you, you know what I'm saying, handle a situation for people trying to play you against me? Like, you're better than Lonnie. You know what I'm saying? You deserve better. You should leave. You know what I'm saying? I can make you a star. Just walk away from Lonnie. Like, honestly, how would you? Well, I always wonder these things because how these groups just go away so quickly.
First of all, I know, you know, how I work, what I do, what I bring to the table, and you know, how I play my position. I would never leave anything that I don't feel, that I feel 100% a part of.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been that way forever. And now my new inspiration, thanks to the morning tea with Lonnie Bee, is Big G. And how he says, like, regardless of what happens, like, I'm always going to stay true to Backyard. They are, you know, my popularity. You know what I'm saying? This, mm-hmm. that, ever. So regardless of what, nothing is going to take me away from them because I'm going to stay true to what, you know what I'm saying, it's really me, and that's a part of mm-hmm. me, and they're responsible for a lot of the things that I have now.
Right.
So that's just further stamp, you know what I'm saying, the program I've been running all my motherfucking life. So
right.
And that's the end of that.
Right.
So I understand that.
But when it comes to me, hold on, let me fix my shit, because Ron, you stupid as fuck.
Man.
You know what I'm saying? You know, there's truth in jokes. There's truth in jokes. There's truth in jokes.
You said that the other day.
So. Yeah, there's
no,
truth
it really
jokes.
Is.
No, it is.
That's okay, because if you leave, let me tell
and
you,
that's how
you leave. You elbow head motherfucker. You better make sure that motherfucking $1 million lasts you for the rest of your life. Okay.
And then, and not only that, let me say this. We have more of a thing that we can actually build an empire together, but we don't even need that. That $1 million would never be, would never amount to what you have and what you're building right now.
Mm-hmm.
I agree.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
that's great. So, but what I was about to say is, my thing is, when it comes to people, first of all, can't nobody come to me with the offer. I'm going to set my own offer. That's number one.
Yeah.
That's how much I believe in myself. Okay. You know what I'm saying? If uh-huh. you want to come to me and put something on the table, trust and believe, I'm going to rearrange that shit right. to make sure that it's not a me thing, but it's a we thing.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Now, my thing is, though, I have been tested plenty of times because I feel like at times I'm too loyal. Okay? I have really been tested, but I'm not about to put that person out there like that because, you know what I'm saying, I'm rekindling my friendships but loving people from a distance.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm talking about.
I don't.
Yes, okay?
I don't.
And it could be.
We went out recently.
Okay.
But you know what I'm saying? It's just like I have been tested for my loyalty because sometimes I'm too loyal. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, I respect my loyalty because it's my loyalty that got me this far. And yeah. I understand now at this day and time, just because people treat me a certain type of way, I don't have to treat them a certain type of way. Exactly. Even when it comes to the DMV. Exactly. And I go to a lot of people's shows.
Exactly.
And they never come to mind.
Exactly.
But I still continue to go.
And that's right.
Because I feel like me showing respect and just who I am. I have blessings, you know what I'm saying, piled on my lap. So why should I be upset at you?
And you're doing it because you actually want to do it.
Yeah, and I'm just that type of person. I like supporting people.
But you can't help it.
Never come to my show.
And I told you that.
And I got friends like Ron in my ear, like, stop going to that shit.
But it's something that you like. This is the thing. Like, just like they have the audacity to do what the fuck they do,
right.
You got the audacity to do what you do.
Mm-hmm.
By you being the person who you are, you must always remember it's just crazy. And that's something that you have to live in that everybody don't understand.
Right.
So that means that you will be put and used in so many different ways that the average motherfucker right. is not going to be put in that predicament.
But see, that's
so,
what I think.
Go ahead. So, and this is what I'm going to say. Just because they don't do it, you can still do it, and don't let dealing with certain people change the person that you are, because right. the person that you are is just why you're so blessed.
And that's my thing when I say loyalty. People don't understand. People don't understand the whole fact and value of loyalty. You're not being loyal to a person. You're actually being loyal to who you are.
Exactly.
If you have a good heart, keep that good heart. You're loyal to your good heart. Right. You know what I'm saying? If you have the same mind, keep that same mind and be loyalty to your sanity. It really has nothing to do with anybody else. It's just you're doing right by others to receive your blessings from God. Right.
But all you're doing is acting as yourself, and yourself is just being a beautiful person and doing certain things, and that's why things come back.
Right.
The way they come back.
100 times.
And everything you just said, you're 100% right. And I give you credit for how you are with that shit, because like I
and
like
you just said, he enjoys going to shows. Mm-hmm.
But the fact that he does support so many, and I just had a conversation with him about this shit 2 weeks ago. Like, he show a lot of love and a lot of support for other people. Like, these people start up businesses and shit like that.
And that's why all these good girlfriends and the million motherfuckers that we have no idea who they are personally is loving him.
No, but what I was saying was,
I know what you about to say. Go ahead.
Oh,
mom.
Yeah. Ooh.
Like, the way he handles that shit is astonishing to me. And I tell him that because he shows when motherfuckers coming up with ideas and businesses and got shows and shit like that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And this man puts them on a stage with him. Like, it ain't about him. He put the motherfuckers on the stage with him.
Yeah.
But when it come to him throwing some shit like that, he don't reach out to nobody. And me personally, I feel as though them people should be running to him. And, hey Lonnie, what you need, what you need? And me and his ear, yeah, sometimes I do say, man, fuck them, man. I do say that because
I get more upset at it
for him. Not for him, but I'm really upset about the shit, at the way that shit get handled. But, you know, he explained to me where he come from, and then I kind of settled down, and I'm like, okay, I see where you coming from with it. So that's why I said,
but with the whole fashion show thing, there's no way that that's supposed to happen, because the whole fucking Chet Maloney was a goddamn fashion show platform. Mm-hmm. It was more episodes on fucking Chet Maloney about people in their groups than any fucking thing else. I know, because I was a co-host then, okay?
Right.
If you don't know. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Then you got Fashion Fridays and all that shit.
But people don't look at it like that. You live in a world where people want to take and not give.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? But if you be more like the world, you will never be special.
That's true.
If you be more like the world, you will never be special. So that's why I decide to do my things my way. It don't really hurt me. And Ron, you got to break out of that.
You're right.
No, you got to break out of that.
No, you're right.
Because you a tick-for-tack nigga. No, you are. Yes, you are.
Be.
No,
bro.
You living
this shit. Sometimes you need a tip for tap motherfucker on your team now.
No, but that's not always good.
But
And see, that's what I was saying. Like,
two wrongs don't make a right.
Sometimes it do.
No, it don't, Ron.
Sometimes it fucking do.
No, it don't.
But two rights can make a wrong.
You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you got to do the complete opposite to teach a bitch that don't know better.
Yeah.
Right.
That's what you got to do.
You had a Martin Luther King look at things. And I had a Malcolm X look
at things. No, I don't have a Martin Luther King look at things.
That's a nonviolent type of, I'm going to do me. Not in the sense of violence, but in the sense of what you do. Like, you're going to continue to bless people. You're going to continue to bring them on.
But okay, so pause right there, because you about to take this to a Nino Brown segment. Okay. What you have to look at is not what a person say, but the example they set. Right. And the affection and the appeal that they have on people. Mm-hmm. That's what you have to look at. So never look at what I say. Always look at what I do.
Right.
Now, I can sit here and preach blue, 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 blue. But if it's nothing behind what I'm saying, all I'm saying out of my mouth is bullshit. Now, if you see your friend Lonnie doing this, saying this, going here, doing this, you know, we out in places, girls running up, we running up to each other, we hugging people, you know what I'm saying? People coming to shows, giving me gifts, stuff, something that came from something.
Right.
That came from something. So the person that's getting all of that is doing something to make these people feel some type of way.
We're doing something for their
so lives. Don't listen to what that person say. Watch the reaction and then start to believe what that person is telling you.
Right. And I do. Like, when you explain to me, you calm me down about the situation because I was kind of heated. I was like, damn, that makes sense. And I understand what you're saying. So, yeah, I agree.
Mm-hmm. Well, very good. Yes.
Very good.
Yes. Simi, give us your tea before we get out of here.
Okay, so really quick, this is crazy as shit. It's a motherfucking story about two nasty ass motherfuckers fucking in the courthouse on the full floor. But stupid enough to post it to social media, and now authorities are looking for them. Or I guess they already caught them. I'm not sure because it was last month. And
that's disgusting. Why would they fuck in the courthouse and record it?
Because it's just nasty.
They was doing that shit for Pornhub.
Yeah, she's the fucking porn star. She's 26 years old and her name is Brittany Jones.
Mm.
And then the other dude is 35. Well, the dude is 35 years old. His name is Jeremiah Robinson. Now, Brittany Jones is a real fucking porn star, bitch. I seen her Twitter, bitch, and she's just like going in.
Mm.
Fucking machine dicks and stuff, you know? She's nasty.
The things that people do for attention.
The things that people do for this attention, honey. So anyway, this was you know, in Florida, and they had sex in the courthouse called Duval County courthouse in Florida. So basically, they wanted on charges basically for unnatural and lascivious acts. Neither Jones or Robinson are courthouse employees, of course, because she's a fucking thought. But the video, he looks like he's a janitor or something, but they say they don't work there.
Mm.
But to make a long story short, you know, basically she was there for an arraignment on drug-related charges early that morning. I guess she felt like, you know, she made it through and she wanted to get it in.
Mm.
So they went to the full floor of the courthouse and fucked in the hallway.
Mm.
Anyway, her father was very disappointed. He told the TV, one of the local news stations there in Florida, that he's very fucking embarrassed. This is not the first time that she put crazy things online and all that crazy ass shit. And then that's what made me look her up. And she's a fucking thotty, Bugatti bitch. But she's a nice looking girl, though.
Mm.
But she's on that Twitter going live fucking machine dicks.
So if she's nice looking, then she needs to follow Jeremy Meeks and be a model.
I know.
And not a porn star.
But she wants to get fucked.
Oh my. Well, she could do that in the privacy of her own home.
But she wants to do it in public.
That's terrible.
And she likes to put it online.
Oh, man. And don't get paid for it?
Well, hopefully one day I guess she'll get paid for it, because I don't know.
Oh, my God. Yes. People, be more smart, okay?
They said they need their ass whooped for doing that shit.
Yes, think about your future, not for the right now.
And I also saw on her Twitter that her and Jeremiah is not fucking with each other because he done bashed her in the head with a damn bottle.
Oh, my God.
She said, no more Bonnie and Clyde.
Oh, no. Damn. Well, maybe they need to settle her down. All right, y'all. Thanks for tuning in with the Morning Tea with Lonnie Bee. Yes, I appreciate y'all so much. Google girlfriends, homeboys, and haters. And yes, remember, if nobody told you they love you today, we do.
Love you to death.
I might don't see you guys on Thursday. Yes.
Tuesday.
I'm sorry. I might be back on Thursday with the Morning Tea with Lonnie Bee. Yes. And I won't be sitting in here by myself. Yes. Waiting for the tea party.
Yes. I will be
waiting. Okay. I will be on tour and I'm excited. Yes. I can't wait to see my Google girlfriends. It's going to be lit tea. Yes. So I'm kicking off my tour on this Saturday at New Orleans, and I cannot wait to get there. All tour information is on www.goodmorningbitch.com. I love y'all so much. I appreciate y'all. And remember to let no bitch upset you. Not one. See y'all later.